हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम रोहिणी दम फ्रॉम KTHM कॉलेज, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस। टुडे वी हैव लर्न अबाउट यूनिट फर्स्ट, एक्सेस कंट्रोल एंड द इंट्रूजन डिटेक्शन। इन दिस सब्जेक्ट, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू साइबर सिक्योरिटी और द इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी, हैविंग द मॉड्यूल 3, इंफॉर्मेशन एंड द नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी। In this session, we learn about overview of IDS. In the previous session, we have learned about overview of the identification and the authorization. In this session, we learn about overview of the IDS. Overview of intrusion detection system. An intrusion detection system is a system that monitors network traffic for suspicious activity and issues alerts when such activity is discovered. It is a software application that scans a network or a system for harmful activity or policy breaching. In this session, we learn about what is an intruders, then types of intruders. After that, we learn the concept of an intrusion. Then what is an IDS, then classification of the intrusion detection system. After that, the function and the principle of intrusion detection system as well as the intrusion techniques. Intruders, one of the two most publicized threats to security is the intruder and other is the viruses, often referred to as the hacker or the crackers. It will access, means unauthorized access to the data, resources as well as the programs, or the it will also misuses the privileges. Types of intruders. In an important early study of intrusion, Adelson identifies three classes of intruders: masquerader, misfeasor, clandestine user. Masquerader, an individual who is not authorized to use computer and who penetrates a system's access control to exploit a legitimate user account. Then misfeasor, a legitimate user who access data, programs or resources for which such access is not authorized, or who is authorized for such access but misuses his or her privileges. Then clandestine user, an individual who seizes supervisory control of the system and uses this control to evade auditing and access control or to suppress audit collection. The masquerader is likely to be an outsider. The misfeasor generally is an insider, and the clandestine user can be either an outsider or an insider. Intruder attacks range from the begin to the serious at the begin end of the scale. There are many people who simply wish to explore internets and see what is out there. At the serious end are individuals who are attempting to read privileged data, perform unauthorized modification to data or disrupt the system. Some examples of intrusion: performing a remote root compromise of an email server, defacing a web server, then guessing and cracking password, then copying a database containing credit card number, viewing sensitive data including payroll records and medical information without authorization, running a packet sniffer on a workstation to capture usernames and the password, using a permission error on an anonymous FTP server to distribute pirated software and music files, then dialing into an unsecured modem and gaining internal internet access. These are the some examples of the intrusion. What is an intrusion? Any set of action that attempts to compromise the confidentiality, integrity or availability of a computer resource. Then, consequences of intrusion. Intruder attacks range from begin to the serious. At the begin end of the scale, there are many people who simply wish to explore the internet. And what is out there here? At the serious end, intruder may be attempting the following. Means, it will read the privileged data, perform the unauthorized modification to the data, or disrupt the system setting. Intrusion detection system. Any unauthorized access not permitted, attempt to access, damage or malicious use of information resources. Intrusion detection system is a system that monitors network traffic for suspicious activity and issue alerts when such activity is discovered. It is a software application that scans a network or a system for harmful activity or policy breaching. Any malicious venture or violation is normally reported either to an administrator or collected centrally using security information and event management, that is SIEM system. This system integrates outputs from multiple sources and uses alarm filtering techniques to differentiate malicious activity from false alarms. Although intrusion detection system monitors network for potentially malicious activity, they are also disposed to false alarms. Hence, organization need to fine-tune their IDS products when they first install them. It means properly setting up the intrusion detection system to recognize what normal traffic on the network looks like as compared to malicious activity. Classification of intrusion detection system. IDS are classified into 5 types. First one is network intrusion detection system are set up at plant point within the network to examine traffic from all devices on the network, and it performs an observation of passing traffic on the entire subnet and matches the traffic that is passed on the subnet to the collection of known attacks. Once an attack is identified or abnormal behavior is observed, the alert can be sent to the administrator. An example of an IDS is installing it on the subnet where firewalls are located in order to see if someone is trying to crack the firewall. Next one is host intrusion detection system, that is HIDS. It run on independent host or devices on the network. A HIDS monitors the incoming and outgoing packets from the device only and will alert the administrator if suspicious or malicious activity is detected. It takes a snapshot of existing system files and compares it with the previous snapshot. If the analytical system files were edited or deleted, an alert is sent to the administrator to investigate. An example of HIDS usage can be seen on mission critical machine, which are not expected to change their layout. Next one is protocol-based intrusion detection system. It comprises of the system or agent that would consistently reside at the front end of the server, controlling and interpreting the protocol between a user device and the server. It is trying to secure the web server by regularly monitoring the HTTPS protocol stream and accept the related HTTP protocol as the HTTPS is unencrypted and before instantly entering its web presentation layer, then this system would need to reside in this interface between to use the HTTPS. After that, next one is application protocol based intrusion detection system, means APIDS. Application protocol based intrusion detection system is a system or agent that generally resides within a group of server. It identifies the intrusion by monitoring and interpreting the communication of application specific protocols. For example, this would monitor the SQL protocol explicit to the middleware as it transacts with the database in the web server. And last one is hybrid intrusion detection system. It is made up by the combination of two or more approaches of the intrusion detection system. In the hybrid intrusion detection system, host agent or the system data is combined with network information to develop a complete view of the network system. Hybrid intrusion detection system is more effective in comparison to the other intrusion detection system. Intrusion techniques. The objective of the intruder is to gain access to the system or to increase the range of privileges accessible on the system. Most initial attacks use the system or software vulnerabilities that allows a user to execute code that open a backdoor into the system. Alternatively, the intruder attempts to acquire information that should have been protected. In some cases, this information is in the form of a user password. With knowledge of some other user's password, an intruder can log into the system and exercise all the privileges accorded to the legitimate user. Typically, a system must maintain a file that associated a password with each authorized user. If such a file is stored with no protection, then it is an easy matter to gain access to it and learn password. The password file can be protected in one of the two ways. First one is one-way function and second one is access control. Access to the password file is limited to one or a very few accounts. A basic technique for gaining access is to acquire a user password, means administrator, so the attacker can log in the exercises all the access rights of the account owner. Typical intrusion scenario. There are the some steps in the typical intrusion scenario. First one is information gathering. After that, further information gathering. After that, attack, successful intrusion, and at the end, fun and profit. In the first step, information gathering, find as much as information as possible. Who is lookup and DNS zone, transfer, normal browsing, and gather the important information. Second one is further information gathering by using the ping, sweeps, port scanning, or the web server, or the version of application and the services. It will gather the further information. Then next one is starting. Try out different attacks and try to find the misconfigured running services. And at the end, passive attack or the active attack. After attack, then the successful intrusion. Here, install own backdoor and delete log files and replace existing services with the own Trojan horses that have backdoor password or create own user accounts. And then it will hack all the details of the administrator, and at the end steal confidential information and use this information for the unauthorized use, and use compromised host to the launch further attacks and change the website or the get fun. Why we can use IDS? There is a straightforward reason to protect data and system integrity. There is one fact behind the IDS cannot be done with ordinary password and file security. And next one is the misconception. Means here, a network firewall will keep the bad guys off my network, right? Or my antivirus will recognize and get rid of any virus I might catch right here. And my password protected access control will stop the office cleaner and through my network after I have gone home, right? Means here we just consider I am protected, but there is some threats, means the intruder, which can steal your data. There is some reality. Antivirus system are only good at detecting viruses. They already know about it. And password can be hacked or stolen or changed by other. Firewalls do not recognize attacks and block them. And hence, we can use the IDS. Function of IDS. First one is, IDS detect attacks as soon as possible and takes the appropriate action, or it will report to the administrator. And then IDS does not usually take preventive measures when an attack is detected. It is a reactive rather than proactive agent. At the end, it plays a role of important rather than a police officer. There are some principles of intrusion detection system. IDS must run unattended for the extended periods of time. Then IDS must operate without unduly affecting the system activity. IDS must stay active and secure. IDS must be able to recognize unusual activity, and at the end the IDS must be configurable. Component of IDS: database knowledge, detection engine having sensor, then database configuration, decision engine. Intrusion detection system that monitor network events for sign of malicious activity have become an integral component of security, and IDS monitors the network traffic for suspicious activity and alert the network administrator. An IDS, as shown in this figure, is composed of several components. Sensors are used to generate security events, and a console is used to monitor events and to control the sensors. It also has a central engine that records the event log by the sensors in a database and uses a system of rules to generate alerts from security event received. The two common types of IDS are based on the pattern recognition or anomaly detection techniques. The pattern recognition based IDS monitors packets on the network and compares them against the database of signatures from known malicious activities. It raises an alert when there is a match. On the other hand, anomaly detection based IDS work by establishing a profile for a system normal activity. It raises an alert when there is a conflict between observed activity and the normal profile. And to reduce the complexity of the overwhelming alerts generated, the ideas, the new technique called alert tracking have been proposed to create comprehensive alert report. Here, the alerts that are related to each other would be grouped together as attack tracks. At the end of the session, we have learned about overview of ideas. In this topic, we learn what is an intruder, types of intruders, then what is an intrusion, then classification of intrusion. Then we learn about what is an ideas, then what is the need of ideas, function and the principle of the intrusion detection system, and at the end, component of the ideas. Thank you.